This question is from NEET 2019, paper code P1, question number 11. Question is, two similar thin equiconvex lens of focal length f each are kept coaxially in contact with each other such that the focal length of the combination is f1. When the space between the two lenses is filled with glycerin, which has same refractive index as that of glass, then equivalent focal length is f2. The ratio f1 by f2 will be. So there are two parts of the problem. In the very first part, we have two similar thin equiconvex lens. They're in contact. So let me just draw the diagram for that. This is the first convex lens, let's say, which is in contact with the other convex lens. Now, try to understand this. This is the glass, so mu for this is 1.5. Mu for this is also 1.5, right? Now, since they are in contact, so their power will be added. If the power is added, that means the focal length of this equivalent length is going to be 1 by f1, which is given in the problem, right? So 1 by f1 will be, since this is a convex lens, so it is 1 by plus f, other one is also the convex lens, so it is 1 by f. That means 1 by f1 will be 2 by f. So f1 is going to be f by 2. Right. Now, in the second part of the problem, gap between these two convex lens is filled with the glycerin. So this question now becomes like this. Since gap is filled with the glycerin, so this becomes the combination of three lenses. Now we have two convex lens, and this part, the middle part, is going to be the concave lens now. Means we have two converging and one diverging lens, right? So its refractive index is 1.5. In between we have glycerin. Whose mu is also 1.5, and this is the glass whose mu is 1.5, right? Now, if you talk about the focal length of this diverging lens, that will be negative. So we have two positive focal length and one negative focal length. According to the problem, this combination has equivalent focal length f2, so it is going to be 1 by f minus 1 by f plus 1 by f plus focal length. Positive focal length is 4 converging length, and negative 4 diverging length. So this and this will get cancelled out. From here, easily we can understand f2 is f by 1. Let's say this is equation number 2. Now we have to take the ratio of these two, f1 by f2. If you will take the ratio of f1 by f2, easily you can understand this is f by 2 by f by 1. So that is f by 2 into 1 by f. So f and f will get cancelled out. This is 1 by 2, which is 1:2. So let us check which option is correct. Option 2 is 1:2, so option 2 is the correct option. Thank you.